Since the new mode, Basketball, just came out, figuring out how to actually shoot the ball consistently and how to outplay your opponents is going to give you a massive advantage and is going to let you rack up a ton of trophies since a lot of people don't know how to do that. So at the end, I'll give you tips on how you can make your shots consistently, but first let's talk about overall strategy and good brawler choices for Basketball. So tanks are always going to be great in this mode because they have a ton of health and the field is pretty small, so you can just walk across a good portion of the field while holding the ball and you won't die. So they're very good offensively, which means in this mode, you really either just want to play a tank or a tank counter. And on top of that, effects that push back or slow or stun are absolutely necessary because it can force your opponents to drop the ball or at least prevent them from getting close to your net. And that's going to let your team get ahead and prevent your opponents from really being able to do anything. So with that being said, there are really only a couple brawlers you want to choose from in this mode. In terms of tanks, El Primo and Frank are definitely your best options. They both have a ton of HP, even as far as tanks go. Primo has pushback with his super and with his gadget, and Frank has the stun with his super, and he can stun a lot of people at the same time, so it's very good in that respect. And Frank, on top of that, just has a massive area of effect from his main attack, which covers a large portion of the map and shuts down any plays your opponents are trying to make. All the other tanks don't really match up to Primo and Frank because they don't have the same stun or pushback capabilities, they don't have as much DPS, and they don't have as much HP as well. Now, in terms of tank counters, you probably want to go with Colette or Ems. Colette because she absolutely shreds Primo and Frank, and she gets that pushback effect with her super using the push it star power, so that's going to get some last minute saves if your opponents are just about to score. And Ems for similar reasons, she shreds through tanks with her main attack, and she slows them down with her super, and on top of that, her gadget also gives you an extra pushback effect. So Colette and Ems are two brawlers that both counter tanks very well and have these great effects built into them. There are other decent options like Bee and Gale, but these aren't quite as good as Colette and Ems, because Gale really doesn't have as much damage to finish off the tanks quickly like you're gonna need to be able to do, even though his super does have a great pushback effect. And then Bee does have a decent amount of damage, though not quite the same as Colette and Ems in terms of how quickly she's able to melt through brawlers like Primo and Frank. And the slow effects from her super and gadget are pretty good, but not quite as good as if you had a pushback or stun that would force your opponents to drop the ball. So in terms of overall strategy, if you're playing a tank against a comp that doesn't really hard counter tanks, you can basically just pick up the ball and walk wherever you want for a decent amount of time without dying. So you basically just want to keep rushing the ball and going for quick and easy points. If you end up dying, it's not the end of the world because you're going to charge your super a lot from all the damage you take, and you're just going to respawn in a perfect spot to defend your own net. You're going to have all your health, and you're going to recharge your ammo in a very short amount of time. Primo is a lot better at playing this way. Frank usually wants to focus on control a bit more, but definitely can still make these plays by just rushing at your opponent's net constantly. But Primo definitely wants to play very, very aggressive and just go straight for the ball, straight for your opponent's net, and get those points as quickly as possible. And if you ever get very heavily damaged as a tank, usually it's not even worth it to heal. You just want to die, so that way you can respawn with full health in only 5 seconds, because a lot of times it takes longer than that to heal up, and you're going to be in a weird spot off on the side of the map hiding so you don't take any damage, whereas if you just respawn, you'll be right in front of your net and ready to take out your opponents. Now, if you're not playing the tank and you're instead playing the tank counters, you want to focus mainly on defense since you don't have as much health. You don't want to cheese as many points as you would with Frank or Primo, so you just want to focus down on the enemy's tanks, particularly the Primo, so that way they don't do those hyper-aggressive plays, and just make sure you save your pushback effects for right when your enemy is about to score. That's the best time to do it, because if you use it before then they'll know you have it gone, and then they can quickly rush your net and you'll have no defense because you'll be waiting for your gadget or your super to charge again. Now, if you do play a tank counter, you are kind of relying on your teammates to play a tank so that we can get close to your opponent's net very easily. If that's not the case, then you just want to play a very slow, control-based match, wait to get a full team wipe on your opponent's team, and then you can go in and get the points. So now we have to actually talk about getting those points and converting when you have that opportunity to actually throw a shot at the net. It feels a lot like RNG, but you can actually get some very, very consistent shots once you know exactly where you need to aim, because the way it looks on the screen is a bit deceiving from how the hitboxes actually work. So it's always going to be significantly easier to aim if you aim from the bottom half portion of the half circle that tells you where the three-point line is. That's because when you're at the bottom, your aiming line will sort of overlap with the net, and it's easier to line up things like that. It's not impossible to hit from the top, I just find it to be significantly easier at the bottom. Now, if you're shooting at the net from the side, you have to time your shot right with the up and down movement of the basket, as well as make sure your left to right distance is correct, so that way it doesn't come up short of the net, and to make sure that it doesn't hit like the back part of the rim and bounce out because of that. So those are two things you have to keep in mind, whereas if you shoot from the bottom, all you have to do is time the up and down movement of the basket since you're already aligned from from left to right from where you're standing, and that doesn't move when the basket moves. So that's always going to be the most consistent, is if you stand directly at the bottom. I actually like to stand slightly to the left of the very bottom, because that way the aiming line doesn't overlap with itself and you can actually see where your aiming line ends, but it still gets most of the benefit from standing at the bottom. There's very little aiming you need to do from left to right. And now here's the most important part where I think people come up short. You always have to aim for the back part of the net, or it looks like it's closer to the top of the screen. If you look at these shots, this looks like it's aimed so that the ball is basically gonna land right in the center of the basket, but it actually doesn't make it because it hits the bottom or lower rim of the net and bounces out because of that. But here it looks like I'm aiming a bit higher from where the center of the net would be, but it actually goes in. It bounces off that back part of the net and goes in, almost like that part of the net is a backboard, just rotated from where the backboard actually is. But I found that aiming for this point, trying to bounce off that back part of the net, is extremely consistent once you get used to it after a few games. Now in pretty much all my games, this is how I score all my shots, is just by bouncing it off the back part of the net and having the ball drop in from there. So that is the portion of the net you always want to aim for, because that's where the hitbox is gonna let the ball actually drop through. If you end up aiming from the side because maybe you don't have the opportunity to aim from the bottom like I was talking about before, then you can actually look at the shadow of the basket beneath it to predict its up and down movement. That's gonna be a bit more accurate than looking at the basket itself because it is offset because of depth perception and all of that. So looking at its shadow is gonna be a bit more accurate when you're lining up your shot. Now in terms of how far you should lead your shots, the basket is actually gonna move at most one tile away from where it initially is in the time from when you shoot the ball to when the ball makes contact with the net. So that's how far you need to lead your shots. It's always gonna be one tile or less because the net slows down right as it's about to change direction. And you really want to know when that point is, when the basket is going to turn around. You'll probably get a feel for this if you play many, many matches, but for the time being, what you can use is these little visual markers. So when the backboard is just a width of the rim higher than the top yellow barrier, then it's gonna switch direction and start going downwards. And when the backboard is a width of the rim higher than the middle yellow barrier, it's gonna start going back upwards again. So when you see the backboard is getting close to that position, you know that the net is about to change direction. And so you don't need to lead your shots as much or even at all if it's really close to that point. And that's gonna let you aim your shots more consistently because you know exactly how the net is going to move. The final thing you need to know when playing basketball is that if you're going for a 3-point shot, which is really important if you need that 3-point shot to win the game, your hitbox, which is just a little bit smaller than the circle that's below your feet, that needs to be fully outside of the line or else the 3 points won't count. And you always want to get 3-point shots with your super, typically bouncing off the backboard if possible. I find that to be the most consistent way to score these 3-point super shots. It is possible to do it without your super, but I haven't found a way to do it consistently yet. And every time I've seen it, it's always bounced off the rim. And you never really want to try to get it in by bouncing off the rim because that's extremely inconsistent. So I don't recommend trying that unless it's the only possibility you have and time is about to run out. But otherwise, I would charge up your super, make sure your hitbox is fully outside the line, and then go for a shot that banks it off the backboard. So now that you know how to aim in basketball, make sure to take the ball from your randoms when you're playing, because you're the only one who actually knows how to shoot properly now.